Hey everybody, how are you doing? I hope you're all doing well. Today I want to talk about something that is called center image or soundstage or sometimes even three-dimensional sound. I want to discuss what it is, how you can improve yours, and if you really need to have it. It isn't rocket science, so let's go! So first of all, what is the thing they are talking about when you hear someone talking about soundstage or stereo field or center image? Well, it's the thing that happens between your two speakers. And a good calibrated stereo setup does in fact give you the illusion that there actually is sound coming from in between the speakers. On my setup, when I pan something to the center, I clearly hear it coming out of the wall. And this is a really strange thing when you hear this at first. So the clearest and most amazing stereo image I've ever heard was during a listening session at Vandenhul. It's a guy that makes pickup needles and coils and stuff, and also makes very expensive cables. And in his listening room, I really had the illusion that there were much more speakers even around me. And that got me thinking how to improve your own setup so you get a more solid and better stereo image. Because it isn't only about the equipment, it's part of it. So first of all, speaker placement is everything. And of course you can measure it and do all that kind of stuff. But what I like to do is having two extra persons in the room that help you with the speaker placement. And what I ask the people is to move the speakers inwards, move them outwards, or even angle them towards me or away from me. And what made a really big difference in my setup was lifting the speakers a bit higher and then vertically tilting them towards me. It's a real small tilt I'm making, but if I'm not doing that and I'm lowering the speaker so they will be at ear level, then the bridge of the console will also be interfering with them. So that's the reason why I've lifted them up a bit and angled them inwards. I know that a lot of acoustic guys will go completely crazy about this, but this was actually the best compromise to make. So listening while other people are moving your speakers is one of the ways to improve your stereo image. Just close your eyes and focus on what is happening in between your speakers. And as soon as you've got the most sound coming out of somewhere where there isn't a speaker, then you are doing well. So I've just talked about having a bridge in front of your speakers, which is worsening your stereo image. Another thing that is worsening your stereo image is a monitor of a computer. And this is an issue in a lot of studios. And it's also a pain in the ass for a lot of acousticians and a lot of people that build those studios. They really hate the screen in the way. What I would advise, and one of the cool things that I might be doing to my studio in the future, is making a screen on the wall. So it's not in the field of the speakers. You can also bring your speakers forward so they are at the same line of your monitor, but then they are really close to your ears. And that also doesn't really work. Of course, it's not only the placement of the speaker, but also the type of the speaker. And this is something you cannot quickly manipulate, because you need to buy different speakers, maybe. The way the filters are designed to cross over the different drivers in your speaker are really important. Also the placement of all the coils and the tweeters and stuff. And what are the names in English? I don't know. You understand what I mean. And it tend to be that the more phase linear a speaker is designed, the better your stereo field and stereo image will be. So it's also important that both the speakers are really matched. As into the small details, it has to be completely matched. And not only your speakers, but actually your whole signal flow from your converter to your speakers. And even the converter. Because to be honest, when I switched to Motu, my stereo image became much, much better. And I didn't even thought it could be better in this room. But it did, and that was really an eye-opener for me, because I didn't believe in like better conversion technology will make a better sound, and I didn't really believe it. It did, it really did. It's so much clearer and so much more solid in the center. It's hard to describe on a video. So the last thing, and this is also the most important thing, are acoustics. And of course acoustics, there are a lot of things in acoustics that you can do. So there are two things that I think are really important for stereo image in acoustics, and those are, well, the first thing, your first reflection points. So the point on the wall where the audio makes the first reflection to come back to your ears. And the closer the wall is to your ears, the more the difference this makes. So the best is to have infinite far walls out of you, but that's not possible. But that can make a big difference. And you can slam an absorber on it, a Rockwool absorber or a prefab absorber. Make sure it's a pretty thick one. Stick it on there and your stereo image will improve. I also need to do this still in my room. I'm already very happy with my stereo image. Another thing that you can do is put a diffuser on it. Making a diffuser is much more work, but does give different and most of the times better results. So the second acoustic thing is your back wall. If you're sitting close to a back wall, so having a back wall behind your head, then treat that back wall and make it as absorbing as possible, if you ask me. Because that back wall will also, you know, fire music back to you, and that will also mess a lot with your stereo image and with your stereo field. Even if you don't think it will, try it out, get a carpet somewhere and put it behind you, and you will hear an improvement in stereo image. So does this all matter? Do you really need to have a good stereo image? The answers are, again, somewhere in the middle, yes and no. I think you need it because it will give you a much better capability to balance everything, since you can hear the whole spectrum much clearer and you can hear the balances in your mix much better. Also, what I have experienced myself, the better your stereo image is, the less listening fatigueness you will get. So the more comforting your sound is to listen to, because your brain doesn't have to fill in the gaps. On the other hand, why I don't think you need it is because, well, who cares? A lot of listeners aren't listening in an ideal stereo position. They most of the time just listen on their iPhone speakers. If they're listening on earbuds or headphones, however, then they will hear the difference between a very well-made stereo mix or even 3D mix. But then still the question is, do they care about it, or do they just want to listen to the song? It's always difficult to make a balance between that, and whenever you have time, whenever you are freaky enough to work on it, you know, it doesn't hurt anyone to make your own stereo field and your own stereo image on your own monitoring system better. But if there are other things in your signal pad that needs more attention, then I would recommend you to first work on that before you work on your stereo image, because it's not that important. And with that being said, I want to end this video over here. If you liked it, let me know with a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, then you know what to do. This video is made possible by patrons. I will link a link to my campaign over here. Also, while you're here and you want to watch more of me, hard to imagine, but if you want to watch more of me, do it over here. Thank you a lot for watching this video, and I will see you guys again tomorrow. Bye bye.